Hi, it's Johnny, and tonight I'm going to do Endless Love by Luther Vandross and Mariah Carey. I've never heard the song, I've never heard anything by Luther Vandross. For a while, when I was thinking about doing this, I had this 60s pop song, Everlasting Love, in my head, so I'm just way off base with this whole thing. I've looked it up, and there's a version of Lionel Richie and Diana Ross doing a duet of this in like the 70s, early 80s kind of time. I'm guessing this is that song, and this is like a 90s update, so let's see how it goes.
Like from out of a dream. And in this dream,
where's that, the Royal Albert Hall?
There was a major diva in the wings, waiting for me. Oh yes, she will appear out of somewhere.
I think this is 94, is that right? That Luther can sing that. Their voices complement each other so well. I thought his would be bassier. It's quite a fine voice. Interesting. I like this.
That's
Love. Really good.
Thank you.
Do you think the new show's coming on?
Mariah Carey!
Or was that a proper surprise?
Mariah!
Yay! Thank you, Luther.
Thank you!
I like that a lot. I've not heard a lot of duets, but I was amazed how well their voices complemented each other, like the actual sounds of the voices. But then the intricacies of the phrasing, the ad-libs that probably weren't ad-libs because he copied some of hers and they did some at exactly the same time as well. So I kind of felt like it was very planned, as you would. And I think you're at the Royal Albert Hall. You might rehearse it a couple of times. And very free and easy, wandering around the stage, looking at the audience, not always making eye contact with each other. Sometimes that makes me cringe a bit in a duet when they're too close to each other, not breaking eye contact. I guess there's probably occasions where that works, but it always comes across a bit phony to me. This felt a bit more natural. It's packed full of great moments. After the first verse chorus, there was a bit where it calmed down a bit. I think they walked opposite sides of the stage. And then Mariah does something that gets the audience clapping, and I can't quite remember what it is, but we're going to watch it again. A nice note, it's just the way she gets to that note. There's a nice bit, and then there's almost a bit where she breaks into that last note, and I guess that's what triggered that in the audience. It's very interesting how their voices work together. I've only heard this one song by Luther Vandross, but I guess throughout that his voice is very consistent. It's the same tone, it sounds the same basically. Whereas hers, she's got all the vocal acrobatics that she can do. And I feel in this, it sounds more breathy, there's more bits where it breaks. One of you, I think Julius, was it you, was saying that in 94 her voice does get a bit less bassy, a bit less deep. So maybe I'm seeing that here, the lighter side of her voice. I'm not sure about the breaking and the breathiness and all those other things that I'm noticing. I guess she's been doing those all along, but maybe that comes out a bit more in this era too. So although I didn't know where the song was going in terms of the melody and the verses and the choruses and everything like that, and I didn't know which ad-libs he's going to do and whereabouts he's going to take it. So his voice seemed like the solid bed of this, whereas hers was a bit more unpredictable. I didn't know where it was going to go melodically, but I also didn't know what kind of voice I was going to get, what technique she'd be using. Really interesting. I enjoyed that performance a lot. Lovely one. I'll do some more Luther Vandross. No, I won't. I'll listen to some more Luther Vandross on my own time. I'm not going to do them on the channel. I'm keeping it just to women. I've got to focus it somehow, and I like all the different kind of genres, time scales. I've got to focus it somehow. So just women. Men can come on if they're doing a duet, but apart from that, it's female voices of whatever kind. All right, so thanks for voting for that. Really enjoyed listening to it. Number 2 and 3 on the poll, I think, were America the Beautiful and If It's Over on SNL. So I'll do those at some point in January, February. That'll definitely happen, so thanks for that. Okay, that's warmed me up nicely because I'm about to do Anytime You Need a Friend, Tokyo Dome. That's for YouTube. So, yeah, can't wait for that one. See you soon. They were like, what was that noise?
The palace.
It was a whistle. This is the first recording, first song. Jackson 5's last song.